Dublin, Ireland, the one, the only, the notorious Conor McGregor!
You grew up in Ireland. When did you realize, at what age did you realize that you were good at fighting?
Well, what age did I mean, I'm Irish. We're all good at fighting.
Conor, you were an apprentice plumber, right?
Yeah.
And is that something that you wanted to do, or was that something you were pretty much railroaded into?
Yeah, you know, like, the Irish mentality is when you finish school, if you're not going to college or anything, you have to get a job straight away. There's no chasing your dreams and doing what you want to do, you know what I mean? It's get a trade or get in and do a job. So I got the first trade that came my way, which was plumbing, you know what I mean? And I just realized I didn't want to go down that route, you know what I mean? I thought I could do something with my life, and I knew I had the ability to make it in this game. It's more like an obsession now. Everything I do is something to do with this, you know? Everything it's always in my head. I'm always thinking about it. I'm definitely obsessed with it.
Mixed martial arts is basically the purest form of unarmed combat known to man. It involves all disciplines, all combat disciplines, boxing, kickboxing, wrestling, taekwondo, karate, jiu-jitsu. It's just a pure combat.
My name is Conor McGregor and I live in Lucan. I'm a professional MMA fighter with a record of 4-1. My dream is to be world champion, world lightweight champion in the UFC, have more money than I know what to deal with, and have a great life for my kids, my grandkids, everyone in my family, everyone that's come up with me. That's my dream. My dream is to be number one, pretty much. My goal is number one in MMA. Words can't even describe, but it will happen, and I'll let you know when it happens.
Pushing his midsection and immediately opening up.
Conor looking so settled already. And that's that capoeira style of striking that he's been using. He's fixing everything up so nicely, really taking Bushinga by surprise. And that left is getting through. It's like a piston spearing through the Dublin air, straight onto the chin of Ivan Bushinga. And it's having a home repeatedly. How very tough is Bushinga? Shot.
Wow!
Bushinga's completely out of it! What a spectacular knockout by Conor McGregor! As we are bombarded with his fans around the commentary position.
Covered in rather a lot of beer as well, Joe.
And now, in two division, CWFC World Champion, the notorious Conor McGregor!
Congratulations.
come on.
Do you think the call is?
Yeah, I'd hope so. Yeah.
Next fight will be.
I don't know. We'll see what happens. You know what I mean? Just keep positive and again, keep believing, keep training, keep trying to learn every day, trying to learn new shit every day. That's it. If the call comes, the call comes. You know. So.
Thanks very much, Conor. And not to take anything away from the two belts, but I don't think you'll have a chance to defend them because your next fight will be in the UFC.
Thank you, man. I appreciate
that.
Thank you very much.
When I first hear, I first heard about Conor from the internet, which is where you hear about everything, right? There's some wild, brash dude out of Ireland that was kicking people's asses and doing it in spectacular fashion. And, he's got that thing, you know, whatever it is. He's got talent, obviously. He's got speed, excellent striking technique, excellent wrestling and jiu-jitsu, but he's also got that thing. It's hard to figure out what that thing is, but you know when people have it.
1 hour to go, on weight. One of the biggest arenas for the UFC. How are you feeling?
Yeah, I feel good. It's done now, you know what I mean? The hard work is done. I
I earned my money already making the weight, and I'm on weight now. And I'm just chill out time, put on the scales, and then eat food.
All right, we'll do a little video after the weigh-ins.
Yeah.
And feel even better.
It's the Bama Beast, Marcus Brimage, against Conor, Notorious McGregor.
Yeah, I'm fighting Marcus Brimage. Again, I don't like to think of a style, or I don't like to think about, you know, it's just, again, it's me versus me, you know what I mean? He's not, the opponent doesn't come into the equation, you know what I mean? I just focus on what I'm going to do. Again, be spontaneous, be creative, go out and have fun, let things happen naturally. I'm going to go in and represent myself, my gym, the country of Ireland. I'm going to go in. I can see him hitting air a lot. I can see me making a miss. I see a good night for myself here.
Marcus Brimage, Conor McGregor, and here we go.
Out of Conor's 12 wins, 11 are knockouts.
Conor with an uppercut there, Kenny.
11 are knockouts, and he almost did it again. He can fight going forwards. He can fight going backwards.
Look at that uppercut.
Now, Marcus
is hard, looking to finish it here.
This is why everyone's been talking about Conor.
It's all over.
Dana, 60 G's, baby.
And for Conor, you right over here. You have been very stoic there with the sunglasses, kind of just looking ahead, not really reacting to much. What's going through your mind right now?
Not much, you know. There's two things I really like to do, and that's whoop ass and look good. And I'm doing one of them right now. And Saturday night, I'm gonna do the other.
Max Holloway looks to derail the oncoming force that is Conor McGregor.
This guy's a normal dude from Ireland, one UFC fight, and this place is on its feet. I know this is Boston, and I know they're Irish, so, you know, I grew up here. I know they go crazy for anything Irish, but this is something unusual. This kid's got something.
Conor McGregor taking on that man, 21-year-old Max Holloway, and it'll be interesting to see how Holloway responds to the pressure fighter, and it's McGregor landing early.
Oh, look at that front leg hook kick. Where do you see that? This karate style stance. It's very unpredictable, along with a background in amateur boxing. Look at this wild stuff.
It is hard to simulate this type of pressure in training.
You know, you can call it 3-1, but it's even more significant than that because it's the only real hard strikes are being landed by Conor.
Now, I gotta tell you something, man. I've been in the UFC for a long time. I've never seen a fighter with only one fight in the octagon get as much hype behind him as you. You hear that? That's not normal, man.
My name, McGregor, you know, that's bled on the battlefield. I have no doubt my ancestors were on the war-torn Scottish Highlands, you know, and in them days, riding a horse, swinging a pickaxe, you know what I mean? That was where I was from.
I talk a lot, but I back it up.
Conor McGregor is such a fascinating guy in that, yes, he's super talented. You know, the question is, can this kid break into the top 10? Can he break into the top 5? And can he challenge for a world title? If he can, oh my God.
Someone asked me what it's like when I make that walk, what it's like when you walk out to that arena, and I swear on my life, when I walk out to that arena, I honestly feel like I'm unshackling chains off of me. Do you know what I mean? I feel like I'm chained and I'm carrying a cross or something. And then when I get to that octagon, I'm peeling it all off. And when I finally step foot in that octagon and place my bare feet on that special UFC canvas, I feel free.
If you want to touch gloves, do so now. Back to
the court. It's the top of the bill showdown. Five-minute rounds in the featherweight division.
Both guys starting out with a whole different range of techniques. We've got some head kicks, some spinning kicks. Brandel's looking for a takedown here. Working for a takedown. He gets it, and Conor reverses in the air.
He's a clown that I want to silence. I want to do it for Brazil and for the United States.
Good stand-up there from Brandel. Nice shot. Nice right hand from McGregor as he stands. Nice head kick. Stalking his opponent.
a world champion in the UFC. And Conor, he's a clown. He's a joke to me. I'm so looking forward to this, man, to shutting this guy's mouth.
It's fear manifested in a different form.
Shit, boy.
Make no mistake, he's afraid. He's a scared little boy. And panic is setting in, and that is that. I sit back, smile, go in and put him away in one round. And we will talk again on Saturday night.
He's funny, he has the nation behind him, but most importantly, it's because he can fight.
Follow my instructions. We're going to have a clean fight. You can touch gloves at this time if you wish. Let's do it.
This fight between Poirier and McGregor. Here we go!
Immediately, McGregor opens up with a hook kick.
Yes, southpaw,
spinning back
nice.
Kick to the body. And again,
Conor McGregor said he's really worked on his kicks for this fight.
Oh, he tagged him in the left, Mike. He heard
him. Up top.
He heard Poirier with that left.
Right in front of him.
He's talking to him now, Mike.
Hands at his hips. Having a conversation. Looking to finish the fight.
That's it.
It is all over.
What have you done to get people so excited? We've tried to figure it out. I can't figure it out. You're spectacular in your victories, but there's something else.
I don't just knock them out. I picked around. This is the new age. I wanted to come over here to America and show the American public the new era of the fighting Irish. And I brought my whole country with me. We don't, if one of us go to war, we all go to war.
Let's see who has the highest pay-per-view numbers. Let's see who has the highest gate. Let's see who has the highest attendance. Again, I won't look past Dennis. I will look through him, exactly where I plan on going. And then carry on. But I believe 2015 will be my year. I know a lot of the featherweights are bitching and moaning and hating on it, you know, but they don't have to love it. They can even hate it, but they will be forced to accept it.
45 for Conor McGregor! It's one of the reasons that makes him a very interesting opponent here tonight. Here we go! McGregor the southpaw, and he's going to be able to fight to the best of his ability. This is a nice clean left hand by Conor. I mean, Conor McGregor is making a very strong argument that he is as special as he says he is.
Oh, took his time, dug one into the ribcage, and again, refuses to be put on his back.
He really is getting eaten alive. Final seconds of the round.
Small island called Ireland. And right now, Conor McGregor is as famous as anyone who comes from there.
And there's that jump roundhouse kick that he's been doing to the face.
His favorite striking technique, and they say the punch that lands, that's what McGregor
hard
just
left
did
hand.
There.
This could be it.
This may be it.
Conor McGregor very trying close, to finish this fight.
This fight is seconds away from being stopped. That's it.
It's all over.
Look at this. He's going to Jose Aldo. Look at this.
Look at Jose Aldo.
It's not all talk here. I'm gonna wipe out everyone in this division. I said that, and I will do it.
He just does that kind of things to make fun. But with me, he's in deep shit.
O Aldo vai te pegar!
Aldo will get you!
O Aldo vai te pegar!
Aldo will get you!
O Aldo vai te pegar!
Ooh, vamos ré! What you got to say now? Face to face. Man to man, what you got to say? What you got to say?
We sit between Conor.
News came out on Tuesday, initially from the UFC Netherlands account, that UFC featherweight champion Jose Aldo had suffered a rib injury and his status for UFC 189 would be in question.
Andre Pettineras, his coach, called and basically said that Aldo's rib is too painful and he will not be fighting. So Chad Mendes now will fight Conor McGregor for the interim belt.
My mind is absolutely bulletproof, solid as a rock. I am number one. So if you are number one, who gives a shit if number two steps out in place of number three?
I'm going to destroy your life. You know, you wipe all that hype out of here, I'm going to get in there and destroy this dude. Bottom line.
You know, when the fight edges closer, the face becomes blank. It always is the same. I become colder. So I see nothing. I see an object in the way that's about to get removed. It's all done now. Now it's time to fight. It's time to put up or shut up. After this, he will never speak my name in vain again.
Introducing the notorious one, Conor McGregor!
Lost it in the back up.
uppercut.
And Grinder, Chad can't stand in front of him like this.
Mendez fires back. Looks for another takedown. Not this
Connor
time.
Connor stuffed it.
Listen to this place.
Oh, big shot by McGregor.
Look at the clock closely. 10 seconds.
Oh, he's hurt.
Could he finish him here?
That's
it. It's all over. Connor McGregor is a UFC interim featherweight champion.
Wow. Wow. Wow.
Declaring the winner by TKO, and now the new interim UFC featherweight champion of the world, the notorious Conor McGregor.
Conor McGregor, ladies and gentlemen.
Dana White with some news on season 22 of The Ultimate Fighter coming up.
Well, we're going to do lightweights. There'll be 16 lightweights. There will be 8 from the United States and 8 from Europe. And the coach of the United States will be Uriah Faber, and the coach of Europe will be Conor McGregor.
What's up, gang? Good afternoon.
I don't see Uriah as a competitor, you know, he is just there.
A picture of us real quick. Get his chin out of shot. You should walk around with a car and shake that. Big similar.
He can be up 1 minute and down another, and likes to talk a little smack. I wouldn't say we have, as of right now, a huge beef, but I could easily see things escalating.
Artem, you ready? Let's get it on.
Jab right hand to the body. Jab left hand to the body. Keep that move flowing. Yep. Hey. Nice and playful, Artem. Be playful in there. He's got mutter. Beautiful shot. Sit down. Sit down.
Up. Last day. Oh, look at that hug! I didn't think I'd see you again. You're back around. Good to see you, my friend.
The night after the finale is UFC 194, McGregor versus Aldo. Aldo was supposed to fight Conor, but had to pull out due to a rib injury, and it's a massive fight. So Conor ends up winning the interim title. Jose Aldo is the pound-for-pound best fighter in the world and the only featherweight champion ever in UFC history. Now they're set to finally face off, decide once and for all who is the featherweight champion of the UFC.
Se Deus quiser, nada vai atrapalhar, não, mano. Pode ter certeza que vamos vencer com tranquilidade.
Tá destacado o pessoal do Brasil, Sport TV e Combate, que vai estar torcendo por você.
Valeu, galera. Então, todo mundo tá acompanhando aí, torcendo. Pode ter certeza que é mais uma vitória, isso é certo. Valeu!
I feel I will KO him inside one. If he makes that walk and if he is in the octagon, I feel every single movement I make will get an overreaction off of him because he's emotionally invested in it. There's too much in it for him. The whole country of Brazil, it's all piling on him. So I feel if I just go, he will react a million times too much. That's what I see the fight playing now. I feel him overreacting, overextending, and then being KO'd unconscious.
The new UFC featherweight
champion of the world, the notorious Conor McGregor!
All right, baby, we did it! Yeah!
UFC 194 is wrapped up. We're at the MGM. Dana's on the move. He's got lots of media to do. A record-breaking night. The fastest title fight in UFC history. What went through your mind when that happened?
Holy shit.
The arena.
I mean, there's nothing else to think. I actually thought that fight was going to be like Hagler-Hearns. I thought it was going to be a knockdown, drag him out. You know, that's how they started, like the fight was going to go.
Yeah.
But Conor caught him on the chin, and that was the end of it.
Conor said a lot of things that after he won the belt, he wanted to go up to 155. Do you think that's the truth here?
Oh, yeah. He had a hard time making that weight. And when we got up in there, actually, Kavanaugh said, I don't ever want him making that weight again. It's hard for him, and I don't want him to do it again. So I think he's going to move to 55.
Well, this is listening to SportsCenter. Rafael Dos Anjos has withdrawn from next week's UFC 196 lightweight title fight against Conor McGregor.
All right, Dana, the show will go on. So who is McGregor going to fight?
He will fight Nate Diaz.
Diaz. Johnson.
Just over two on the clock here in round two.
Good counter by Johnson. Both guys connected there. A lot of pressure, and he's landed a lot. There he goes again. Oh, he heard him there. And Nate just pointed to him and said, understand and trade.
Michael Johnson, that man here.
For the winner, by unanimous decision, Nate Diaz!
Conor McGregor, you're taking everything I work for. I'm going to fight your ass. You know what's the real fight, what's the real money fight? It's me, not these clowns that you already punked at the press conference. Don't no one want to see that. You know you beat them already. That's the easy fight. What that real...
I honestly not like... I like Nick's little bro, you know what I mean? How can you not like him? He's like a little cholo gangster from the hood. But at the same time, he coaches kids jiu-jitsu on a Sunday morning and goes on bike rides with the elderly. He makes gun signs with the right hand and animal balloons with the left hand. So, you're a credit to the community.
Fuck you. Fuck you. Bro. I don't give a fuck what you say, motherfucker. Yeah, thugging on mine, motherfucker. What you got?
At all times, follow my instructions. Touch gloves if you wish. Let's do this.
Not a chance. Not a chance. Here we go. Southpaw against southpaw. Spin and a miss. A clinch. Where's the clinch? 22nd in the UFC. Nice jab by Nate, and a good left hand over the top by Conor. 1 year, 8 months. Good left hand by Conor. Post-fight show on FS1, immediately following our pay-per-view. Couple good right hands there by Nate Diaz. Couple good jabs there by Nate. Good left hand by Conor.
Yes.
Takes him down.
He'll pull guard, Joe.
Round
round one in the books. Round two. Connor, good left. Fatigue should not be a factor for either fighter. Connor pouring it on here. There's that uppercut, which in the Diaz world means absolutely nothing. Because he will fight until he can't fight any longer.
Here is the
he tagged him. Got him with a good one there.
He tagged him. He hurt him.
He hurt him with that left. 100%. Oh my goodness! Combination!
Nice knee to the body, by
Shields, Richard Perez and company. Again, Diaz connects. Connor comes back.
He caught him again with a right hook. And another left.
And again with the combination.
And get out of it.
Connor's in serious trouble. 1 minute on the clock. Diaz gets the bout. My goodness. Now he's got
the bout. Now. That's it. He's got the choke.
Nate Diaz.
He's out.
He has done it.
He is
all over. Nate Diaz beats Conor McGregor.
Oh, my goodness. What a night, ladies and gentlemen.
Nate Diaz.
Nate Diaz, you just shook up the world. How's that feel?
Hey, I'm not surprised, motherfuckers.
Thank you very much, guys, and Connor, thank you very much for doing this. Can you describe the emotions after a loss like that?
You know, it stings. It stings real bad, but this is the fight business. I've been on the end of many defeats in my life, and I've rose back, so I will not shy away from it. I will not make excuses for it. I will assess it and come back.